How to change your child's central line dressing with chlorhexidine, also known as CHG. This video will show you how to change the dressing on your child's central line. This will include standard dressing with CHG products. While this may seem intimidating at first, we have confidence that with continued review of this video and practice with your care team, you will feel ready to do this with your child. Preparing your work area and gathering your supplies. Start by cleaning your work surface by wiping vigorously with a disinfecting wipe. Be sure to keep other small children and pets away. Remove or push any clothing that may come in contact with the central line during the dressing change. It is best to have a large area to work with. Then, wash your hands with soap and water for 30 seconds or more. After getting your hands wet with clean, running water, put soap on your hands and rub the soap into a lather. Make sure you get the in-between places, like between your fingers, under your nails, and the back of your hands and wrists. Rinse well under clean, running water while rubbing hands together. Dry hands well with a paper towel or let them air dry. Turn off the faucet, being careful not to touch the handle to keep your hands clean. To protect from any germs, both you and your child should wear a mask. Then, use hand sanitizer and put on clean gloves. Any helper should wash hands, wear gloves and a mask too. Gather your supplies. Dressing change kit. Open the kit, making sure to keep the inside of the kit untouched and sterile. If you need to, it is okay to touch a 1-inch border along the edges of the kit. The contents of the kit are sterile. Do not touch the inside without sterile gloves on. Dressing. Open and drop the sterile dressing into the center of the kit. Carefully grab the packet of sterile gloves out of the kit without touching anything else in the kit. Set the sterile glove packet aside for later. After you have the dressing change kit and the Tegaderm CHG dressing, start gathering your other supplies. Sterile drape, gloves, CHG swab stick, adhesive remover, hand sanitizer, a pen to mark the date on the dressing. Removing the old dressing. After you have all of your supplies, clean your hands with hand sanitizer and put on gloves. Have your child sit or lay still. They should not touch the central line or area around it. This can take practice. You might need help from other adults, depending on the age and needs of your child. Gently begin to remove the old dressing. Use plenty of adhesive remover to help the dressing come off without hurting your child. If needed, use an extra saline flush to put a few drops of saline to remove the CHG gel pad from the skin. It's important not to pull on the line. Never bring scissors near the line to remove the dressing. Some children have a hard time with this step because it can be painful to remove a dressing from the skin, similar to removing a Band-Aid. Go slowly and use your child's coping plan. This step should get easier over time. If needed, ask about working with a child life specialist who can help make a coping plan and offer other support for your child. Throw away the old dressing. Take a moment to look at the skin around the central line. The skin should not look infected or irritated. The skin should look the same shade as the other parts of their body, with no swelling or oozing. Remove your gloves and use hand sanitizer. Putting on sterile gloves. Start by opening the sterile glove packet, like a book. Then, use your non-dominant hand and pick up the glove for your dominant hand by the cuff. Be careful to only touch the inside of the glove. Let the glove hang with the fingers pointing downward. Slide your dominant hand into the glove. If the gloves do not go on straight, wait to adjust them until both of your hands are gloved. Using your gloved hand, slide your fingers into the cuff of the second glove. Only touch the outside of the glove with your gloved hand. Let the glove hang with the fingers pointing downward and slide your second hand into the glove. Adjust both gloves until they fit properly, only touching the outside of the gloves. Hold your hands above your waist to keep the gloves sterile. Now you are ready to touch the sterile supplies. Be careful not to touch anything non-sterile. Putting on the new dressing. Open the CHG swabs from the dressing change kit. We will use these to clean the central line and area around it. Starting at the catheter insertion site, clean the skin with CHG swabs using a back and forth motion. Clean the area a little larger than where the dressing will cover. Do this 3 times for 10 seconds each. Wait until the skin dries completely. If the skin is still wet, it can cause a rash. While you are waiting for the skin to dry, begin to clean the central line with alcohol pads. Start at the insertion site and clean in one direction down the line. After the skin is dry, apply the skin barrier, such as Cavalon, which is a separate package in the dressing change kit. Leave about an inch window around the insertion site. This protects the skin and helps keep the dressing secure. Save the extra skin barrier for the last step to secure the dressing around the edges. Make a loop in the central line if recommended by your care team. Apply the dressing over the central line. Make sure that the gel pad covers the insertion site. Finally, remove the paper border of the dressing and smooth down the edges. Write the date on the dressing so you can remember when it was last changed. Add the leftover skin protectant along the edges of the dressing. Your child's dressing change is now complete. If you're concerned about your child's skin near the line, or if something didn't seem quite right, be sure to contact your care team. If you have any questions, ask your care team.